Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Dafda, and in this 74th video class of DIP, we will study structural methods in object recognition for digital image processing and its implementation in MATLAB. We are learning object recognition, and in previous video class, we studied decision theoretic methods of object recognition. In this video class, we will study structural methods of object recognition. Starting with the name, why these methods are called structural methods? These methods are called structural methods because here we take into account the structures of different shapes. That is, these methods are qualitative methods where we see the quality. For example, the value of shape number, and if the order and the value of shape numbers is matching with the object that we want to recognize from our database, then that will be a correct match. So rather than the quantity of the object such as area, we are more interested or we are looking for the quality of the object such as shape number. Okay, so let us start. This is the slide that we understood in our previous video class also. Object recognition is the automatic identification of the objects by the computer. This can be done using two methods: decision theoretic methods that we have already understood in the previous video class, and structural methods which we are learning in this video class. The decision theoretic methods are quantitative methods where we are interested in quantity such as area, length, etc. And structural methods are qualitative methods where we are interested in patterns that are arranged in strings or tree structure. And therefore, it is called structural method. So, the techniques discussed in decision theoretic methods deal with patterns quantitatively and largely ignore any structural relationships inherent in pattern shape. That is, decision theoretic methods, which we learned in the previous video class, focus on numbers and don't pay much attention to the ways things are arranged in a pattern. Whereas the structural methods are all about recognizing patterns by paying close attention to how things are arranged qualitatively or connected in the pattern. Now, as the decision theoretic methods are of three different types, similarly, the structural methods are of two different types: matching shape numbers and string matching. Matching shape numbers is a structural method in object recognition that involves comparing objects based on their first difference chain code representations to determine if they match or not. So we compare the shape number of the object that is present in our database, which is the template we can say, to the object that is present in our image based on the first difference chain code. And if they are matching, the object is recognized. Second is string matching. String matching is a structural method in object recognition that involves comparing the object's boundary encoding as a string with a reference template to determine if they match. So here we are matching our object's boundary encoding string with the string of the reference template which is present in our database, and hence we do the object recognition. Let us first understand matching shape number in detail. Now, as the name suggests, matching shape numbers means we will be matching the shape numbers, two different shape numbers, one shape number that is present in the database and the second shape number of the object that is present in our image. So this is the slide that we studied in our video lecture number 70, boundary descriptors, where we understood simple boundary descriptors, shape numbers and Fourier descriptors. Shape number is the first difference chain code of smallest magnitude, and the order n of a shape number is the number of digits that is present for the shape number. So for any object, we first find out the chain code, then the difference chain code, and we make that difference chain code of the smallest magnitude like this, and that is our shape number. Now say, for example, this is the shape that is present in our database. I will call this as A. This is my image that has three different shapes, B, C and D. So obviously the shape numbers will be different. Now say the shape number of this database object is small a, the shape number of this B circle is small b, of this triangle is small c, and again this is the square. So order of shape number of this small square will be same as the order of the database shape number. This again will be A. So hence I can conclude that my object D, which is present in the image, is equal to the object A that is present in my database. Why? Because the order of shape number of D is same as order of shape number of the object A. Now the degree of similarity K between two shapes is defined as the largest order for which their shape numbers still coincide. So here the order is the order of the shape number. Say for this smaller square, the order is 4, which is matching with the larger square order, which is also 4. Say if this is having order 6 and is also matching in the database. Say for example, if it is at order 8 and this also is matching at order 8, but this object at order 10 is not matching with this object at order 10. That means they are matching for the largest order 8. And for 10, they are not matching. Then the degree of similarity small k is equal to 8. Why? Because 8 is the largest order for which this smaller square object is matching with this bigger square object. So for this object recognition, we can draw the similarity tree like this. So for drawing this similarity tree, we have to start with lowest order, and we know that for four directional chain code, the lowest order is order 4. So say for example, we find that for this lowest order 4, all these shapes A, B, C and D are similar, and so we keep them at degree 4. Again at degree 6, we find that A, B, C and D are similar, so we keep them as it is. But at order 8, we find that B, C are different and A, D are different, so we keep them at order 8. But at order 10, we find that again A and D are different, and of course B and C are also different. So we can say that shape A and shape D have the largest order A for which their shape numbers still coincide, and their degree of similarity is K is equal to 8. So hence, by placing the objects at different nodes, we draw the similarity tree. Okay. So if SA and SB are the shape numbers of two closed shape objects A and B, then the shapes have a degree of similarity small k if SJ of A is equal to SJ of B. This means that the first k digits should be equal. So here the subscript J indicates the order, and obviously for four directional chain codes, the minimum order for a closed boundary will be equal to 4. Alternatively, the distance between two shapes A and B is defined as the inverse of their degree of similarity. So D of A comma B is equal to 1 upon small k. That means more is the degree of similarity, the smaller is the distance in between A and B, and this distance between A and B satisfies the following properties. Now suppose that we have a shape F and we want to find its closest match in a set of 5 other shapes A, B, C, D and E, and from the figure we can see that F is matching mostly with C as compared to other shapes, and up to degree 6 we can see that all the shapes are matching, and shape F and C match uniquely, having a higher degree of similarity than any other two shapes. So from this similarity tree we can write the similarity matrix like this, where we can say that if A would be unknown shape, then A is similar to shape B, C, D, E and F with a degree of similarity up to 6. The second type of structural method is the string matching. Now this string matching is similar to the shape number matching. Just the difference is that this involves comparing object's boundary that is encoded as a string with reference to some template encoding that is present in our database. So suppose there are two region boundaries A and B, and P represents the number of matches between the strings, and a match occurs at kth position if AK is equal to BK. The number of symbols that do not match is given by Q, and the measure of similarity is given by R, which is equal to number of matches upon number of mismatches, that is P by Q. So here figure A and B are the sample boundaries of two different object classes that is present in the database. C and D are their corresponding polygonal approximations, and E, F and G are the tabular representations of R, that is simple measure of similarity. So as we perform the shape number matching, similarly we can perform the string matching for structural method. At the end, let us implement this shape number matching in MATLAB. So that is all for this video class. With this, we complete our chapter on object recognition. You can find the link to download the PPTs or class notes in the description box, and also the MATLAB code is given in the description box. Thank you very much.